Starting off our list at number 10 is Kathy Griffin. The successful actress got herself into a lot of trouble when she posted an inappropriate picture back in 2017. She decided to team up with Tyler Shields to do a very controversial photo shoot of her holding a decapitated bloody head of Donald Trump. Of course, it was just a mask, but the image was so real and graphic that sites had to blur it and block it from their sites. When she first posted it to Twitter and saw people's horrified reactions, she began to tweet out that she went too far and she will be removing the picture. But a site came forward saying that Griffin and Shields were joking on set of the photo shoot, saying after the photos were released, they would need to move to Mexico because they would be put in prison. She took down the picture and apologized for offending people. But months later, she took her apology back and told the Rolling Stone, and I quote, "I'm not sorry, I take the apology back 1000%. The actress has received death threats and hate mail and was put on a no-fly list after undergoing 2 months of federal investigation. Her last TV booking was in 2016, before the controversy, and the only thing she has coming out in 2019 is a TV movie called A President Show Documentary, The Fall of Donald Trump. She just doesn't know when to call it. At number 9 is Taylor Lautner. Ladies, calm down. Before you get all defensive, ask yourself when you last saw him in a big Hollywood movie. It's been years. We all know him to play the successful role of Jacob in the Twilight series, but that all came to an end, and that is when he had to create a career outside of that role. In 2011, he had the lead role in an action thriller movie called Abduction, which should have set his acting career in motion. The movie received mixed critics and didn't do as well as they thought it would at the box office. He was casted for smaller roles after that, like 10 episodes as Dr. Cassidy Kasade on the TV series Scream Queens in 2016. There isn't much on his resume after that, and that could be because he was accused of having showmances with co-stars, which is not a rumor you want going around. Maybe he'll make a comeback one day. What do you guys think? Sliding to spot number 8 is Isaiah Washington, the actor who is known for his role on the famous TV show Grey's Anatomy. He found himself on Hollywood's blacklist after he made some homophobic comments at the 2007 Golden Globe Awards. This is what had his career come crashing down because he was already on thin ice for insulting his co-star T.R. Knight with homophobic language just a year earlier. After the incident at the Golden Globes, he was put in executive counseling, but not too long into it did Grey's Anatomy decide that he was going to be fired and his contract would not be renewed. After being fired, the actor was asked about it and he said, and I quote, "After the incident at the Golden Globes, everything just fell apart. I lost everything. I couldn't afford to have an agent, I couldn't afford to have a publicist, I couldn't afford to continue." The former television star has found a way to continue on by starring in B-list movies and any projects that he can still get his hands on. Sliding into the number 8 spot is Tobey Maguire, or Peter Parker as we know him. He was at the height of his career during the 2007 Spider-Man adventure, but the series reboot also meant the end of his career in some ways. Let's be honest guys, he kind of fell off the map. After the Spider-Man success, he continued to act in other movies, but they just didn't do well. In 2011, he starred in the romantic comedy The Details, which received mixed reviews about his performance. Then in 2014, he starred in Pawn Sacrifice, which had positive reviews, but was a box office flop. The film cost $19 million to make and only made $5.6 million back. He went MIA in 2014, and we've only seen him in 2017 when he did voiceover work in The Boss Baby. It's not that Tobey Maguire has had some sort of Hollywood meltdown or crazy behavior, he's just not being hired anymore for big roles. Poor guy. Coming in at number 6, we have Dane Cook. The comedian's career took off with his stand-up comedy talent, but also headed into the direction of acting. He made his first on-screen appearance in the movie Employee of the Month, where he starred next to Jessica Simpson. Unfortunately, his first major role was a flop and the movie received 20% on Rotten Tomatoes. He tried to make a comeback when he took on a major role in Good Luck Chuck. The movie was given horrible reviews and received just a 5% on Rotten Tomatoes. He continued to try and book acting roles, but fans were not thrilled about it and often said he should just stick to a stand-up comedy. He is a funny guy, don't get me wrong, but there's more to acting than just being funny. Not only were his movies a flop, but his comedy took a hit after he made an inappropriate joke back in 2012 about a mass shooting. He made a joke referencing the shooting that happened in Colorado during the screening of The Dark Knight Rises. The actor apologized later for his jokes, but some people weren't so forgiving. Lately, he's also caught up in another controversy by people judging him for dating a girl who is only 19 years old. They began dating when she was just 18 years old and he was 45 at the time, and the two have continued dating for over a year now. People have had no problem voicing their opinion on the 26-year age gap. Dane is making a comeback though in comedy by doing a comedy tour this year. He admits that he will be sticking to comedy and that acting is in his past. I think it is best that that stays in the past. Halfway through at number 5 is Jeremy Piven, the actor known for his role in the comedy series Entourage, for which he won a Golden Globe Award and 3 consecutive Emmy Awards. Talk about being a successful actor, right? It wasn't until he had sexual assault allegations surface that his career began to take a major blow. In 2017, reality star Ariane Belamar alleged on Twitter that Piven had sexually assaulted her in the past, once at the Playboy Mansion and once on the set of Entourage. Soon after, Cassidy Freeman also accused him of sexually assaulting her when she was younger. Jeremy went on to deny any accusations and said they absolutely did not happen. On November 27, 2017, CBS decided not to order a full season of his show Wisdom of the Crowd following its weak rating and his allegations of sexual harassment. Later in January 2018, BuzzFeed published an article in which 3 more women accused Piven of inappropriate sexual behavior. He's too busy fighting all these horrible accusations to be going to any auditions for his next role. Not that he would be casted anyways after allegations and publicity like this. Swiping our number 4 spot is actress Tara Reid. Most of us girls will know her from her role in the movie Josie and the Pussycats, and most guys will know her from the American Pie movies. The actress was once very successful, finding her way to play the hottie in most of her movies. She did go on to land a role in the TV series Scrubs, which allowed her to show her talent outside of the comedic movies we always see her in. However, it wasn't long after she left the show in 2005 did she find herself caught up in hard partying, negative publicity, and awful plastic surgeries, which is a shame because she was naturally a very pretty girl. All these things have been enough for studios to have been turned off from casting her, and she now finds herself booking a lot of smaller roles in short films and other projects. Up next in number 3 is Amanda Bynes. The Nickelodeon star was once in the prime of her career. She had a successful career which began in 1998 and went all the way until 2010. Through different TV shows and movies, she had a huge fan base to support her as an actress. One of them was me. She even had her own show called The Amanda Show. That's when you know you've made it. But the last movie we saw her in was Easy A all the way back in 2010. After that, her career began to crumble along with her reputation. In 2012, she was arrested for drunk driving and hitting the side of a cop car. Luckily, no one was hurt, only minor paint damage was done to both vehicles, but she was arrested for the DUI. After that, fans started seeing Amanda get a little out of control. She began tweeting inappropriate comments about other stars and even called President Barack Obama and his wife ugly. She also pulled a Britney Spears and shaved half her head and then filled both her cheeks with dermal piercings. She started walking the Hollywood streets in crazy colored wigs, trying to hide her face from the camera. In May of 2013, she was once again arrested, but this time for possession of marijuana and reckless endangerment after she threw a bong outside of her Manhattan apartment window. Just 2 months later, Bynes was placed under involuntary psychiatric hold after she started a fire on a stranger's driveway. Yeah, I don't think Hollywood is interested in taking another look at her acting resume after all that screen. At number 2, we have Jack Gleason. The young actor played Joffrey Baratheon in HBO's Game of Thrones. He played the character from 2011 to 2014, but after the boy was killed off the show, Gleason decided he wanted to step away from acting. He was in the prime of his career, but went on to tell interviewers that he didn't want to be in the spotlight and wanted to go back to school. During an interview, he said, I quote, "I hate celebrity culture." He returned back home and is now a part of his Dublin-based theater company called Collapsing Horse. So even if Hollywood wanted a part of him, he wants no part of Hollywood. In our number 1 spot, we have Jussie Smollett, the successful actor for his role of Jamal on the TV series Empire. His story broke the news on January 29th when he went to the hospital saying he was attacked by 2 men who were yelling out racial and homophobic slurs and poured a chemical substance on him. 20th Century Fox and Fox Entertainment offered their support to the actor after the attack was reported. Hollywood and fans both rallied against this hate crime, which led to the 2 male suspects being arrested and charged. This is when the truth came out and the 2 men told the courts that Jussie paid them to stage the whole thing. They even had the $3,500 check as evidence. On February 21st, Jussie was arrested on suspicion of filing a false police report. Under Illinois law, doing this is considered a class 4 felony and could lead to 1 to 3 years in prison with a judge set bond of $100,000. They also ordered him to surrender his passport. The producers of Empire cut his character from the final 2 episodes of the current season and are evaluating all the options for the future. future. Luckily for Jesse, prosecutors have now dropped all the charges against him. Well, isn't that a fair legal justice system? Celebrity status for ya. Starting off our list at number 10 is Eddie Murphy. Yes, the hilarious comedic actor has found himself in some situations that aren't so funny. If you don't know about the story that broke the news, it was Eddie Murphy being arrested in a prostitution scandal. The arrest happened back in 1997, and don't think for a second that Hollywood has forgotten about it. On May 2nd of 1997, the police pulled over Murphy's car at 4:45 after they observed that a well-known transsexual prostitute got inside. Murphy claims that he saw a person was having some trouble and pulled over to ask if they were all right. That's when the prostitute asked him for a ride and he agreed. Murphy went on the record and said, "I did nothing wrong. I was trying to be a good Samaritan and this is what happens." The prostitute was arrested, but no charges were placed on the actor. Good news is, some people believed his side of the story and he still went on to book some good acting roles. However, the story resurfaced in 2015 because only 1 year after Murphy had picked her up, she was dead in a very mysterious circumstance. The case was opened up again all these years later, which brought up Murphy's little run-in with her. The Lip TV posted a video about journalist Mark Ebner talking about Eddie and all his past with different prostitutions. He also shares that he met with one of the prostitutes who's been with Eddie and claims that Eddie's lawyer, Marty Singer, paid her $50,000 to change her story in the tabloid. She even had the check and records to prove it. So Eddie's reputation in Hollywood is no longer a very good one. He has booked some acting work, but nothing that puts him in the Hollywood spotlight like he used to be. And at number 9, we have Felicity Huffman, the Desperate Housewives star. She's currently involved in a scandal that has led to her arrest, and Hollywood is going crazy about it, as well as her fans. Last week, she was caught being involved with a college admissions scam. She was accused of paying $15,000 to William Rick Singer, fake charity to help her oldest daughter Sophia cheat on the SATs. According to CNN, Singer traveled from Florida to West Hollywood to administer Sophia's exam, and apparently she scored 400 points higher the second time. Paperwork shows that the actress was making arrangements to pursue the scheme for a second time for her younger daughter, but decided to back out. This wasn't just cheating on a test, this was a very serious crime. Huffman was arrested at gunpoint at her Los Angeles home Tuesday morning. She was later released on a $250,000 bond. She has received tons of backlash ever since the scam was exposed, leaving her to completely deactivating all her social media. She's been accused of mail fraud and will appear in court in Boston on March 29th. Actress Lori Loughlin has also been involved in the scam and was fired from the Hallmark Channel after the arrest. So I think it's safe to say that people in Hollywood aren't taking this lightly. Here. Swiping the number 8 spot is Jamie Lynn Spears. Yes, Britney Spears has a little sister and she was once a Nickelodeon star with her own show called Zoe 101. She played the title character Zoe, who had a super fun and innocent life at a posh boarding school, unsupervised without her parents. Young fans adored her and her carefree innocent lifestyle, but apparently the actress wasn't so innocent while off camera. She caused a major controversy when she got pregnant at the young age of 16. Not long after the announcement, Nickelodeon canceled the show, which also meant her other co-stars lost the show with her. The once actress became a mom, got married, and then gave up her acting dream and turned into a country artist instead. She's now pursuing a career as a country artist and said she has no interest in returning to acting. She might not get very far anyway, since the only thing on her acting resume was Zoe 101. Taking the number 7 spot is Tyrese Gibson. 2017 wasn't a great year for him, with his child custody case going viral and his bizarre Instagram rants. He made even more headlines when he threatened to leave Fast and Furious franchise over a fight with co-star Dwayne Johnson. It all started when it was announced that Johnson would be starring in a Furious spin-off, which would have to push back the release of the next Furious movie. Gibson was not okay with this and took it to Instagram saying, I quote, "I'm sorry to announce that if Dwayne is in Fast 9, there will be no more Roman Pierce. You mess with family and my daughter's survival, I mess with yours. Close your eyes, dude, you're a clown." Like, what does that even mean? You look like the clown, really. What a joke. He deleted the post and blamed his anti-anxiety medication for the reason he has meltdowns online. Publicly calling out the franchise that made you an international star is never a good idea. It's doubtful casting directors will be banging down his door after that. His IMDb profile can validate that, as he has no credits since 2016. Coming into spot number 6 is Thora Birch, an actress who many of us still watch in her movie Hocus Pocus every Halloween. She began acting as a child and turned into a star in the late 1990s and early 2000s. That's when her career really took off. She received amazing reviews for her performance in the Academy Award nominated film American Beauty, and she also received a Golden Globe nomination for her role in Ghost World. The star has found herself blacklisted from Hollywood because of her difficult behavior. During an interview, when asked about her career, she said, "I pissed off a lot of people over a long period of time and they found a way to upset me, hoping that upset would bring a change in my behavior, like a distancing, but I'm done." It didn't help that a story broke the news that her father, who was her manager for many years, physically threatened one of her co-stars. That's when she was fired from Dracula, the off-Broadway revival. She recently returned to acting a little bit here and there, but it is clear she will never go on to be the star many people thought she could be. Halfway through at number 5, we have actor Shia LaBeouf. His story seems a little tragic to me because he's a really good actor, but apparently he is a troubled individual. He's famously known for his role in the Transformers movies, and more recently for his work done with musician Sia. Although he has been a successful actor, it seems that his ego got the best of him. Hollywood will no longer hire him because his off-screen behavior is too much of a liability. What do I mean by that? Well, he was first arrested at the age of 9 for stealing a pair of Nikes, and later at age 11 for running off with a Game Boy. You cannot make the guys. His third and fourth offenses happened in his 20s, once when he attempted to stab a neighbor, and another when he refused to leave a Walgreens. Then in 2014, at age 28, he was charged with disorderly conduct during a cabaret performance. And then a more recent case of his erratic behavior was in 2017 when he was arrested for public intoxication, obstruction, and disorderly conduct. Things for the actor got even worse when video surfaced of him calling a police officer a effing B-word, while also saying a black cop was going to hell due to his skin color. He has since apologized, but Hollywood and the majority of his fans have not forgiven him. At number 4, we have Ryan Rotman, who began his career playing Joey Colvin in the series Gigantic. His work led him to dating Victoria Justice, who was the star of Victorious. The two were a power couple for young fans, but after the relationship fizzled out, Rotman got into some trouble with the law. In 2011, police officers spotted his car was jumping a curb, so they pulled him over. The cops smelt alcohol and he brutally failed a sobriety test. The actor blew .19 on the test, which is more than double the legal limit. His show was canceled and he was charged with a DUI. Once he faced the court and things settled down, he continued to pursue his acting career. He's been able to book short films and small TV roles, but nothing has brought him back to the big screen. One can only imagine where his career would be now if he didn't get that DUI. Alright guys, at number 3 we have Orlando Brown, the Disney star most known for his role on That's So Raven. He was one of my favorites on that show, so it is a shame to see his successful career crumble. After That's So Raven, he went on to other acting projects and also got into the music industry. Over the past few years, Brown has been in trouble with the law and arrested for multiple different things. He was first arrested for burglary, which was actually caught on tape, rookie mistake, so he couldn't even get away with it. TMZ posted the video of him moments leading up to the burglary where he takes a cloth to cover up the camera, but he didn't even wear a mask to do so. He was also arrested again in September 2018 for another burglary charge in Las Vegas. He remained in jail on $13,000 bail, which includes bail from his previous arrest charges for drug possession, resisting a public officer, and domestic battery. In his latest mugshot, he showed off a new tattoo on his chest, the face of Raven Simone, his co-star from the show. He also had a huge smile on his face, so I guess he's making the most out of his situation? Alright guys, taking the number 2 spot on our list is Brendan Fraser, known for his role in Bedazzled and The Mummy. He was once a very popular actor that many fans adored, but during the 2000s, his career started to fade out, and a lot of people were wondering why. Just last year, Brendan opened up to GQ for an exclusive interview talking about what happened over all of his absent years. He opened up about his depression after his mother's death, which led to an unhealthy lifestyle and weight gain. It wasn't until this interview that he opened up about a sexual assault incident he faced with the former HFPA president Philip Burke back in 2003. He said he held it in for all these years but felt inspired by the current Me Too movement that is going on right now. Brendan said that the HFPA has never invited him back to the Golden Globes ever since the incident surfaced, and he also says no major productions are willing to hire him either. Taking our number 1 spot is the one and only Kevin Spacey. The 2-time Oscar winner now faces felony assault charges. Yeah, I don't think Hollywood is messing around with felony charges, that's for sure. He was most recently known for his DeGeneres' Netflix series House of Cards, a very successful show that his fans loved seeing him on. But things in his career started to change in October 2017 when a story was published by actor Anthony Rapp accusing Spacey of making a sexual advance towards him when he was 14. After the story was published, more than 30 people have come forward with allegations, accusing him of things ranging from harassment to attempted rape. The allegations brought a flood of damage control as multiple Hollywood units have distanced themselves from the actor. It was officially announced that he was fired from his Netflix hit House of Cards, and another actor, Robin Wright, was promoted to the solo lead for the show's sixth and final season. Ouch, that one hurts. Spacey was also supposed to star in Ridley Scott's All the Money in the World, but then they decided to completely cut him from the film and reshoot all his scenes with another actor instead. And it gets even worse. Spacey's representation at Hollywood's prestigious creative artist agency and his publicist have dropped him from their clients' list. I think we can all agree that it makes sense why he is taking the number one spot on this list. Starting off our list at number 10 is Bill Cosby, the actor who has been accused by over 50 different people for sexually assaulting them. The allegations began back in 2014 when he was accused of sexual assault taking place in the mid-1960s. He has been accused by numerous women of rape, drug-facilitated sexual assault, sexual battery, child sexual abuse, and sexual misconduct. As more people started coming forward with allegations, the alleged incident spanned from 1965 to 2008 in the US and one in Canada. After years of battling the accusations, Cosby was first found guilty on April 26, 2018 for 3 counts of aggravated assault. Then on September 25, 2018, he was sentenced to 3 to 10 years in state prison and fined $25,000 plus the cost of prosecution, which was $43,611. Numerous organizations cut ties with the comedian actor and even revoked honors and titles awarded to him over the years. Media organizations polled reruns of The Cosby Show, and TV Land and NBC both ended relationships with Cosby along with others like Bounce TV, Hulu, and BET. I think it's safe to say he'll never be hired again, even when he gets out of prison. At number 9 we have Paris Hilton, if you can even call her an actor. She was the big talk of the town and held a household name for her stupid saying, "That's hot." She had the title of best-selling author at one point in time and was a highly paid actress, model, DJ, and brand ambassador. But we don't quite hear about her anymore, do we? Here's a few reasons why she does not book any more of her acting roles. Well, number one, she kinda sucked as an actor, if you're just going off of my opinion. But a big reason which caused a lot of controversy for the actress was her 2004 sex tape that went viral called One Night in Paris. Paris claims the sex tape was actually put out by her ex-boyfriend and was never meant to be seen by anyone. She says that it has completely ruined her life and is something she will have to explain to her kids one day. She also said that it gave her the title of a slut, which is why she only really booked roles like the slutty girlfriend in House of Wax who gives Roadhead in one of her scenes and then dies half naked in the other. Another reason her career has been affected is because of her political views and being closely tied to President Donald Trump. She has known Trump since childhood, and Trump even took it as far as speaking about her sex tape, saying that him and his wife Melania watched it together. There's a disturbing image none of us need in our minds. And to top it all off, in 2012, a recording of Paris talking in a taxi cab was leaked and it exposed her saying homophobic comments. On the recording, you can hear Paris say, "Most gay men probably have AIDS. Gay guys are the horniest people in the world. They're disgusting. I would be so scared if I was a gay guy. You'd like die of AIDS." When the scandal went public, you can imagine what it did to her career and also her reputation as a decent human being. Sliding into number 8, we have Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen. I think they count as one because they go hand in hand. The Olsen twins is what gave them their career. They've had a very successful acting career ever since they booked their first role on Full House when they were just infants. They continued to act, write books, create a fashion line, and become millionaires by the time they were 18 years old. Their last movie together was New York Minute back in 2004. Unfortunately, the movie didn't impress the media and received some harsh critics and reviews. Some said the movie sexualized the twins, who were only 17 years old while filming it. Gross. It received a 4 out of 10 star rating and 11% on Rotten Tomatoes. It didn't do very well at the box office either. We haven't seen them in a movie together ever since then, and it seems the girls have moved on to bigger and better things. Mary-Kate booked a small role in the 2011 Beastly movie and actually told People magazine she lost her passion for acting. The two were wanted for the spin-off of Full House, but Ashley said, and I quote, "I have not been in front of a camera since I was 17 and I don't feel comfortable acting." Their focus is now on fashion as they run a very successful career in the fashion world. And their little sister Elizabeth Olsen has stolen the acting spotlight and is making her way in the acting industry instead. At least we get to see one Olsen sister. In the number 7 spot is Matthew Underwood. He was one of the co-stars on Zoe 101, where he played the troublemaker boy Logan Reese on the series. He continued with his acting career after the show ended, but in 2012 he got into some trouble. The actor was arrested after police searched his home and found marijuana and other drug paraphernalia. During the home search, he was also reported to be found in the home's master bedroom with a 17-year-old girl. This was a problem because he was 22 at the time and she was legally underage. He was let go and put on probation, but a few months later was arrested again outside a hookah lounge for violating his probation. The actor has remained out of the headlines since that final arrest and also has remained out of the Hollywood acting industry. Next up at number 6, we have Cameron Diaz. I was in complete disbelief when reading about her because I can't believe that Hollywood wouldn't hire her. She's a star. It isn't until I realized that she hasn't actually starred in anything since 2014. That was when we saw her last big hits, when we saw her in The Other Woman, Sex Tape, and Annie all in 1 year, and we haven't seen her since. She was a huge success when she helped anchor the franchises Shrek and Charlie's Angels, but people say all her romantic comedies is what turned her into a box office poison. They call her movies misses because she never wins any praise for her roles. Some fans have said, not me, that they became bored seeing her in the same type of role over and over again. It doesn't help her career that last year she started making jokes that she's retired. In March 2018, her close friend Selma Blair did an interview and said, "I would have liked to do a sequel, but Cameron's retired from acting. She's like, I'm done." This had Hollywood and fans wondering why the 45-year-old actress chose to retire without telling anyone. Not long after this interview came out did it cause controversy for Cameron and her friend. Nothing has been confirmed, but seeing as she's been MIA for 5 years, I think we know where she stands, and Hollywood doesn't have time for those games. Halfway through the list at number 5 is Jeanette McCurdy, a young actress known for her supporting role on the show iCarly. When the successful series wrapped, she got a starring role on Nickelodeon's Sam and Cat. Things for her career seemed to be going great. This was until 2014 when nearly nude pictures of her leaked online. Tensions ran high between the actress and Nickelodeon, and she even skipped the network's 2014 Kids Choice Awards. She took it to Twitter to blame Nickelodeon, claiming that the network had treated her badly. The leaked photos turned into a huge scandal that involved Detroit Pistons basketball player Andre Drummond. Apparently, the two of them had a short-term fling, and when it ended, she humiliated him on a podcast interview. Only a few days later, her pictures were all over the internet, and she claims that it was him. She took it to Twitter and said, "To anyone disappointed, I sent those pics to one person. You can connect the dots. Shocked someone would stoop so low." The actress left Nickelodeon and tried to continue with her career, where she was able to book some smaller roles. Since 2016, she has only booked a few short films. She does do YouTube videos for her fans and continues to try and be a social media personality instead. Coming into number 4, we have Charlie Sheen, the actor who was once earning a whopping $1.8 million an episode for his 2.5 Men TV series. During an interview with Vanity Fair in 2018, he admitted, and I quote, "I've been unable to find steady work and have been blacklisted from many aspects of the entertainment industry." He was once the highest paid actor on TV at the time that his acting career was in its prime. But it went on hiatus in January 2011 when he entered a rehab facility following his history of alcohol and drug abuse. Over time, he had multiple trips to rehab and also had domestic violence charges against him by multiple women. Not long after he was out of rehab did he demand a 50% raise and publicly insulted the sitcom's co-creator Chuck Lorre, which led to his dismissal from the series. He shopped around for new comedy, but the industry is now pretty skeptical about his past. It wasn't until 2015 where he began to keep a low profile after coming out as HIV positive. Some fans have stuck by him, but the majority of the industry has not, claiming that he's uninsurable. Here we are at number 3 with Kirstie Alley. Towards the end of the 1980s, she was one of Hollywood's biggest stars. She received a ton of recognition and praise for her role as Rebecca Howe in the TV series Cheers, even winning a Primetime Emmy for her performance. She also won over the hearts of millions of American males with her stunning good looks. However, she struggled to remain relevant after Cheers came to an end, and some personal troubles led her to gain a significant amount of weight, to a point where she was barely recognized. It also didn't help that she was also closely linked to Scientology, which she sacrificed a lot of personal relationships for. As a result of joining the religion, reports say that many of Hollywood's executives avoided doing any business with her because they feared they would also be labeled in connection to Scientology. For years, her career took a hit, and to most of us, she kind of just fell off the face of the earth. A few years ago, she began a Weight Watchers program and lost some weight, and even landed a smaller role in the TV show The Scream Queens. But that was in 2016, and she has nothing on her IMDb resume ever since then. At number 2, we have James Franco, an incredibly successful actor over the years with an outstanding acting resume, but apparently he can add pervert to it. His career started to crumble back in 2014 when screenshots surfaced of Franco trying to rent a hotel room for him and a 17-year-old girl. The screenshots show her sharing the fact she's underage, and also shows him identifying himself with pictures, confirming that it was really him. He then faced a lot of heat, and rightfully so, of people calling him a number of different names. The press was also on top of him asking to hear his side of the story, to which he apologized and said he made a mistake. His career continued on after the scandal faded out, but resurfaced in 2018 after he showed up to the Golden Globe Awards wearing a Time's Up pin. The pin was designed to show support for women who have dealt with harassment or assault, but after wearing it, he was facing a scandal of his own. Twitter blew up with different women making accusations of inappropriate or sexual behavior from the actor. The controversy started the night of the Golden Globes as women started tweeting the accusations in reference to his pin. One girl tweeted, "Cute Time's Up pin, James Franco. Remember the time you pushed my head down in the car towards your exposed, and that other time you told my friend to come to your hotel when she was 17 after you had already been caught doing that to a different 17-year-old girl?" Interviews with the girls and also Franco started flooding in regarding the accusations. Ever since, he's deleted social media and has stayed out of the spotlight. Hollywood probably doesn't want any part of sexual harassment accusations, which is a shame because he's a very successful actor. Taking our number 1 spot is Megan Fox. Director Michael Bay's first Transformer movie is what turned Megan Fox into an instant star. From then on, Men's Magazine couldn't get enough of her, and directors rushed to cast her in any upcoming action films and other projects. Let's face it, she was one of Hollywood's biggest hotties. When her feud with Michael Bay went viral and caused the majority of Hollywood to strike against her. The feud between the two of them was heavily documented, and the world was thrilled to watch it all go down. It was by 2009 when the Transformers Revenge of the Fallen came out, and that is when the tension really surfaced. It got so bad that Megan called the director a Nazi and told Wonderland magazine that, I quote, "People are well aware that this is not a movie about acting. He wants to be like Hitler on his sets, and he is." She was part of the rehearsal process for the next movie, Transformers Dark of the Moon, but was fired from the movie after the Hitler comment. Bay admitted in an interview that Steven Spielberg said, "Fire her right now," after he heard the horrific comment. She went on to act in movies such as Jennifer's Body, which was a box office bomb and earned a 43% on Rotten Tomatoes. After that, she was casted in Passion Pit, which earned just 3%. I honestly think that's the lowest rating I've actually ever seen on there. Apparently, she's in a movie called Zeroville that's expected to come out this year, but it was directed and created by James Franco, who's also been blacklisted in Hollywood. At least they can all work together and create their own movies, I guess? Starting off our list at number 10 is Mel Gibson. There was a time when Mel Gibson stars shone bright when he starred in the Lethal Weapon franchise and Braveheart, but it seems like his time has come to an end. He's a solid example that one wrong move can take a person down, although he has a few wrong moves. They started in 2006 when Gibson was arrested for DUI in Malibu, California. The actor at the time said, "I was loaded and angry and arrested. I guess I'm not allowed to have a nervous breakdown ever." Oh, come on, Mel, that's not true. We let you have another one in 2010. Who could forget his horrific fall from grace in 2010 when a series of taped phone conversations between him and his then girlfriend were released? You could hear the actor verbally attacking her with profanity, threats, and racial slurs. He called her an effing pig in heat and told her that he hope she gets raped. When doing interviews about the phone meltdown, he had no problem continuing to offend people based on race, sexual orientation, gender, and immigration status. Hollywood began to lose respect for the actor, and so did his fans. He has continued to do smaller films and even finance his own movies, but it's been a long time since we've seen him star in a big Hollywood hit. He's 63 years old now, so I think it might be time to just retire. Quits. At number 9, we have Roseanne Barr. The actress, writer, and producer lost her career after racist tweets were sent out by her, speaking about Barack Obama's advisor, Valerie Jarrett. The tweet was a racist statement comparing Valerie to an ape. After the tweets were sent out and the controversy quickly started in 2018, ABC canceled its successful reboot of her show called Roseanne. ABC went on to reboot the series without her. Barr has now painted herself as the victim, saying that she was fired because of her support for Israel and that the network was looking for an excuse to fire her. Not too long after, she started making another excuse and blamed her co-star Sarah Gilbert for being the reason her sitcom was canceled. The actress has not found work since, and the only publicity she's getting is interviews about the racist tweet and her crumbling career. In at number 7, we have Katie Holmes, the actress who is also known as Tom Cruise's ex-wife. The actress was once in the prime of her career, booking roles in a variety of different movies. It wasn't until she began dating and then later married actor Tom Cruise that her career started to take some hits. Over the years, Cruise has faced tons of heat when it comes to his religious beliefs and his close link to Scientology. It's no coincidence that his ex-wife Nicole Kidman turned her back on him for his controversial religious beliefs as well. One of Katie's co-stars from Dawson's Creek, who remained close with Katie after all those years, says that her career had been blacklisted. They went on to tell an interviewer that her career began to take a downward spiral because Hollywood wants nothing to do with Scientology, which is believed to have skewed results of Oscar voting on more than one occasion. Some people have pointed out that no actor linked to Scientology ever wins an Oscar, like Tom Cruise himself and even John Travolta for his big role in Pulp Fiction. Not to mention, Nicole Kidman was nominated but never won an Oscar while married to Cruise, but after they divorced, she took an Oscar not too long after. Coincidence? I think not. Now that Katie is divorced from Cruise, she has returned to the Roman Catholic Church she used to go to, so maybe she has time to turn it all around if she wants to? Taking the number 7 spot is Allison Mack, who's famously known for her role in the CW series Smallville. The actress has been taking the heat when allegations came out that she was involved with the NXIVM group. NXIVM is a company in New York which is labeled as a pyramid scheme, a sex trafficking operation, and a sex cult. She agrees she was involved in the program when she was younger, but says she left the group before anything illegal was happening. Federal authorities raided an upstate New York residence that's connected to the group this past Tuesday. The residence was apparently a place where female followers would have sex with their leader, Keith Raniere, and get branded with his initials. Pictures have been revealed of the branding initials where you see an RK, but if you turn it sideways, you can also see the letters AM, possibly for Allison Mack. Claims have been made that the actress was Raniere's direct slave and was one of the top members who organized the illegal sex schemes. The woman from the group told investigators that they were subjected to master-slave conditions in which they were emotionally and physically tormented. Allison is sticking up for herself, claiming that she had nothing to do with any illegal aspects of the group. She says she left the course years ago and had minimal contact with those involved. This crazy case has completely affected her career because her name is now officially registered with the NXIVM group, and she is going to plead not guilty as she faces the court. In at number 6 is Taylor Momsen. By the time she was 17 years old, she had already been in the entertainment business for 15 years. Crazy, right? Her parents started her in the modeling industry at just 2 years old, which landed her breakout role as Cindy Lou Who in How the Grinch Stole Christmas in 2000. After that Christmas hit, she landed other kid roles in movies, but started her real career when she landed the role of Jenny Humphrey on Gossip Girl. This is where her acting career really started, but also ended. During her years of filming, she began to have negative feelings towards Hollywood, and it showed. She started drifting towards a music career, which would tuck her SAG card into a file folder. Her innocent good girl next door look began to morph into a goth-inspired rock star, which is when Gossip Girl producers reduced her role on the show until she was dropped as a series regular in season 5. No love or respect lost for Momsen. She's now very successful in the rock mainstream. You just won't find her working as a Hollywood actor anymore. Halfway through the list at number 5 we have Elijah Wood, obviously known for his role as Frodo in the Lord of the Rings movie series. But what happened to him after that? He continued his acting career but got on the wrong side of Hollywood executives when he told the media that the film industry was full of sexual predators that targeted young child actors. Coming from one of the most accomplished child actors of his time, the accusation was damaging on his career. He went on to say that he never experienced that kind of abuse himself, but said, and I quote, "If you're innocent, you have very little knowledge of the world and you want to succeed. People with parasitic interests will see you as their prey." I mean, he's not wrong. After the comments were made, his resume began to dwindle. He began booking voiceover work instead in family-friendly movies like Happy Feet, but began to move away from acting altogether. He started to progress a career as a DJ and even started his own label called Simeon Records. Coming in at the number 4 spot is Kristen Stewart, or as most of us know her as Bella Swan from the iconic Twilight series between 2008 and 2012. It wasn't until 2012 though that her career began to suffer after she was being accused of a cheating scandal. Well, she wasn't just being accused, she was caught. She was dating Twilight co-star Robert Pattinson for years before she began filming Snow White and the Huntsman in 2012. During the filming of this movie is where she met the director Rupert Sanders. The two started filming together in August 2011, and just shy of a year later, they were having steamy makeout sessions around LA. Not only was Kristen in a relationship, Sanders was also married and has 2 children with his then wife, Liberty Ross, the model. It was July 17th of 2012 when the two met up and drove around trying to find secluded places in LA. Paparazzi got the best of them and captured their entire makeout session and series of photos. On July 24th, Us Weekly released the exclusive set of pictures of their makeout session. Both relationships crumbled as well as Kristen's career. Hollywood was turned upside down that the 22-year-old actress would get involved with the 41-year-old director while filming their movie, which in Hollywood is work. It's their job to remain professional. Kristen hasn't starred in a big movie ever since, but she has continued working on smaller projects, none that have made it to theater. Why? Alright guys, at number 3 we have Rupert Grint, our beloved Ron Weasley in the Harry Potter movies. The actor got his big break in the industry when he was just 11 years old. The gig, which ran the course over a decade, secured his place in the film world. He earned the title of one of history's most famous child actors along with his other co-stars. After the 8th and final movie, fans expected Grint's career to take off given his successful position. Instead, he didn't really do much at all. One of the main reasons being that in between the Harry Potter movies, the actor kind of took it easy. Unlike his co-stars Daniel Radcliffe and Emma Watson, who were booking other movies in between. Throughout the entire series, he only booked 3 indie projects, missing out on a huge opportunity to showcase his acting skills. Not to mention his indie products all received horrible reviews. Turns out the actor wanted to quit acting. In 2017, he told Entertainment Weekly, and I quote, "When I started, acting was never something that I aspired to do. I fell in love with it while I was doing it. But I definitely did think, is this really what I wanted to do?" He went on to say that he felt like he missed out on a lot of life and wanted to just be free and live a little bit. When he did ease back into acting, no one really noticed. He's been able to book some smaller roles, but no movies that have brought him back to the big. Taking our number 2 spot is Macaulay Culkin, the child star that won over our hearts in the Christmas favorite Home Alone. His career started off very strong, however, it didn't continue so strong. He did have roles after that, but none of them really put him on the map the way his childhood did. In 2005, he had drug charges against him, which he pleaded guilty to. He pleaded guilty to the possession of marijuana and medication without a prescription. He was given a 1-year for a jail sentence and was ordered to pay his fees, and he was only 24 at the time. This was just a few weeks after he appeared in court to defend the case that was going on against Michael Jackson at the time, who had sexual assault charges against him. Culkin faced a lot of heat for defending the man who was being accused of child molesting, but he stood firm on his beliefs. Now in 2019, at 38 years old, he still faces the heat defending the documentary that recently came out about the Michael Jackson allegations. Culkin has no problem admitting that he spent a lot of alone time with Jackson, but nothing inappropriate ever took place. He claims that they were best friends. The two remained close close over the years, and Culkin is actually the godfather to his daughter, Paris Jackson. The two of them are extremely close and even have matching tattoos. He has stayed out of Hollywood movies for some time now and has turned to live comedy acts where he has no problem joking about the Michael Jackson scandal. You can imagine that some people just don't take that joke very well. Hollywood. Taking our number one spot is Paul Rubens, aka Pee Wee Herman. The actor was huge for this character during the 80s as he took on two feature films and also a Emmy-winning children's TV series. But his image and also his career changed drastically in 1991. During a visit with his parents in Florida, he was arrested for indecent exposure at an adult movie theater because he was spotted masturbating during the movie. He was 38 years old at the time and pleaded no contest and agreed to take part in a new anti-drug campaign to avoid a trial on the misdemeanor charge. After the scandal, Pee Wee toys were pulled from shelves across the nation and Rubens hid from the public eye, pretty much disappearing for the remainder of the 90s. He attempted a comeback, but more charges of sexual nature were brought against him, this time relating to child pornography. Officers seized thousands of items from a collection of vintage gay erotica and also faced claims of owning sexual images of children. It took yet another decade for him to come back to Hollywood, which he did in 2016's Netflix film Pee-wee's Big Holiday. He did receive some positive responses from fans, but also received a lot of negative as they didn't agree with the decision to bring him back. There's really no way he will ever make his mark in the industry again.